Radio Real Estate with Cheryl Garlock. A show about all things real estate and home-related in the Springs and Colorado. Covering topics from buying to selling a home, construction, financing, foreclosures, and more. Helping the consumer be educated and informed. Here's your host, Cheryl Garlock.
Hey, and welcome to the Springs Radio Real Estate Show. I am Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties, and I have got so much to share with you today. So I hope you are straddled in your seats here because we got a hot show going on here. My guest today is Mike Tinlin with Oakwood Homes. Thank you so much for joining us, Mike.
Hey, good morning, Cheryl. Good to be back.
Oh, yes. Always a pleasure to have you back on the show. Now, you know, we do have, it is the month of October, we do have Halloween right around the corner. So I do have to talk about real estate news, that is, it relates to Halloween.
Sure.
And you may have seen some language about this here, but have you heard about the properties that are labeled vampire properties versus zombie properties?
No, I'm not familiar with that.
Okay, well, I think this was an article out of the Wall Street Journal here last week, and they were talking about vampire foreclosures haunt the home market. Now, this is, of course, you know, we're talking national levels here.
Sure.
Because not every area is recovering quite the way we are recovering here. But they're talking about what a vampire property is. So if you hear somebody say, hey, I got a vampire property here, they're really talking about that these are bank-owned foreclosed homes in which the prior owners still live.
Mm-hmm.
So they're still living in it, that sort of thing. And why would that be? That would be because the bank would rather have somebody still in the property than have the property thoroughly abandoned. Okay, now on the flip side, they said that former owners live across the U.S. right now in 47% of the U.S. bank-owned homes.
Wow.
Yeah, so they're not really
free
quite.
Ride.
Yeah, they're getting them a little bit of a free ride because they're not yet ready to belt them out there because at least they're paying utilities. The bank's not having to handle that or winterize it and worry about abandonment. So really, that's kind of a good thing. But eventually, they do scoot them on out. Now, a zombie foreclosure, these come from definitions that RealtyTrack has created here, are properties that have been vacated by their owners but are languishing in the foreclosure process. I mean, they're just empty. They're just sort of zombie land. Mm-hmm. That's kind of interesting.
Very much so.
Now, listen, I got to talk to you about, now, since we're talking about vampires and we're talking about zombies, I've got to tell you guys, there is a thing on today, Saturday, October 12th, in Fountain. You got to take your family out to do this, Mike. Okay, this is great. Okay, this is really good. They have got, in the city of Fountain, they got the Harvest Moon Dance that night. I think it's from 5 to 10 p.m., and it's free admission. But they have another cool thing, and I went to kind of a preview of it last weekend, and it's called the Cemetery Crawl. Now, they have a cemetery down there. It's called the Fairview Cemetery. And what they do is they have these actor pioneers that sort of dress up in character. And they talk about the lives of some, and some of these are kind of really interesting stories about who murdered whom and how did they get away with it. Let's just say the law was a little less rigid then. So they got some great stories there. I think it's $10 for the cemetery crawl. And that thing runs from 10 to 3 today. So you got to really hit that up there. It's really a blast.
Sounds like fun.
It's a lot of fun. Let me give you the phone number if you want to go ahead and call them and find out or else just show up. Fairview Cemetery is at 500 South Santa Fe, but you can call, of course, 719-322-2031 if you want to find out about getting tickets or just show up. They'll be glad to take your money and let you in, but I'm going to guarantee you this, you'll have a really fun time. Now, really quickly, you know, this has just been the last week or two now of this government shutdown business. And how is that affecting us in the wonderful world of real estate here? It does have some effect on us, but it's not going to be a really bad effect there at all. Certain things are just going to be kind of delayed. But a lot of lenders right now have certain criteria, Mike, you know, mm-hmm, that they have to have Social Security verification and an income tax transcript verification. And these elements of the government are offices that are kind of closed right now. We can't get that. But good lenders are really finding a way to work around that so we can still close deals and get that taken care of. Are you guys finding any problems with that at Oakwood Homes right now?
Yeah, same thing. The tax certificates has been a challenge with some lenders, but some of the lenders that we work with have been able to work around that also.
Right. So that's the thing. If you're thinking about buying or selling, or if you're in the middle of a transaction, you need to pick up the phone, call your lender, and get a status report update on how things are going as far as, is your deal going to be slowed down because because of the government shutdown and what you need to plan for and prepare for doing on that there. So anyway, hey, you know, we got a lot more to talk with you when we return here to the Springs Radio Real Estate Show. Mike is going to bring us up to date on what's happening in Banning Lewis Ranch here. So stay tuned for more from the Springs Radio Real Estate Show, and we will be right back.
If you're looking for your dream house or your first house, Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can make your dream a reality. What others say.
Cheryl understood my needs and focused on the properties that most interest me. She helped me to determine which property would be worth the investment of a lifetime and suited my needs best.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interests. Call Cheryl today, 719-321-7600. Online, ColoradoSpringsBestHomes.com.
Oh, I'm proud of the house we built.
Hey, welcome back to the Springs Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties. Now, you know, if you have a question, and I got to tell you, I know you have questions out there. I am ready to answer them. Okay, I'm going to do my best. And I love being a resource to help people with answers. If I don't know the answer, let me tell you something. I know the people who do know the answer, and I love sharing. So my number is, I hope you got your pens and paper ready. If you don't, just make a mental note of it because it's easy. Of course, you know it's 719-321-7600. Now, you can also find me at my website at ColoradoSpringsBestHomes.com. If you've missed a show and you want to hear kind of what we've done again, please go to ColoradoSpringsBestHomes.com and click on the Extras tab, kind of like trailers in the movie, and you'll go ahead and get the podcast there and that sort of thing there. You can go ahead and tune into the show then again as well. And then we also have a video segment too that we also include on there. We do our property showcase there, so you can find out what properties we talked about today back there again at ColoradoSpringsBestHomes.com. So if you got a question for me or my guest, and also you can find my guest contact information on the Extras tab at ColoradoSpringsBestHomes.com, where you can go ahead and contact them and link to their websites as well. So with that said, my guest today is Mike Tinlin with Oakwood Homes. Welcome again to the show.
Thank you, Cheryl. Thank you.
I want to be brought up to date on what is happening with Banning Lewis Ranch. You know, you guys are such a big, large development there.
Yeah.
And so there's always a lot of activity, and you're looking for so many different ways to improve the quality of life.
Absolutely. You know, so we purchased Banning Lewis, again, for those of you guys that don't know, last May of 2012.
You've done a lot in 1 year.
We have done a lot. I mean, we went through a near $500,000 remodel on the ranch house. It has a junior Olympic sized pool, but we really reached out to the residents and found out what they wanted to use the facility for. And that kind of altered what our plans were for it and kind of steered our renovation. So just a beautiful, about a 7,000 square foot facility. There's a splash park there for the kids, outdoor fireplace, outdoor fire pit. You know, it's usable for the residents. They can host parties there. We've had weddings, et cetera. So that's, you know, that's a small piece. We've done a lot of landscaping updating, but you know, just the sheer magnitude of production over there in the last, you know, 16, 18 months has been amazing. I mean, we have sold 240 net houses.
Wow.
Since last May.
We've
closed over 140. So, wow. I mean, you know,
the inventory is starting to build up. The orders are coming in.
Oh, it's, you know, at all times, we always have in excess of 100 different houses in backlog.
Uh-huh.
So in one form of production or another. So, you know, it's been a very, very successful year. Some of the great things about Banning Lewis Ranch is I've been here about a year now, and I'm really starting to learn that, you know, Banning is really far east for a lot of people that have been in Springs for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
But the more you drive up and down that Powers Corridor, that's the new academy.
It is the new academy. Yep.
The location to hospitals and medical centers is just fabulous. Mm-hmm. So when you get out to Banning, you get inside of it and you really get submersed in what a great lifestyle community it is.
You know, and I can't say enough about the what we call it, the ranch house? Or,
yes. Yeah.
Is that what you guys are calling it? The ranch house. Okay.
Yeah, community center.
The community center there. I can't say enough about the value of that to a community, to a family. Because it's like when you want to host, say, a kid's birthday party.
Sure.
Or you have a special function, type of thing. You've really made this, and it is gorgeous. I got to tell you guys, if you have not been out there to see it, you have got to see it. It really is something. But the fundamental philosophy here is that it is for the residents.
Absolutely.
Now, do we have I know you had the pool there.
Uh-huh.
Okay, and you have these big little banquet room type of things there.
Right.
But do you have any other like fitness or anything?
There's a 24-hour fitness facility inside that ranch house also.
Wow.
So all the residents get electronic key cards, and they can access that 24 hours a day.
Wow.
So,
wow.
No additional dues involved there.
You don't have to go very far for that fitness room at all.
No, you really don't.
And it gives you an opportunity to get out of your house.
That's right.
You know,
which
is kind of neat.
Yeah.
You got some trails there too, don't you?
Yeah, I've got trails, parks, playgrounds. I mean, we're working on a couple of new ones right now.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're working on, we actually broke ground on our second village. So we're getting ready to move in there this winter and, you know, doing a lot of study on what the residents use now, what they'd like to see in the future so we can get what we call our park programming really aligned with what the vision of the residents is.
Mm-hmm. Now, let's see. Let's talk about who some of the other builders are in there, because this is not just Oakwood Homes.
No, it's not.
You kind of lay the framework for it.
That's correct.
But who are some of the other builders as far as that's concerned?
So obviously, you know, Oakwood is the developer and the owner of Banning Lewis Ranch, and we also do build a couple of different collections in there. We build a kind of a ranch product as well as a larger two-story, and then we have, you know, it's much more geared to a first and second-time home buyer, smaller two-story product. And then we have Vantage Homes, who's, you know, a local private builder.
Mm-hmm.
Vanguard Homes, local private as well. Classic Homes.
Local private.
Needs no introduction at
right.
all. And then we have D.R. Horton in Richmond on the little bit larger scale. So the six of us, you know, really deliver square footages and price bands that are going to meet really every buyer's needs that are out there shopping for a new home.
And you can be, you can buy any one of those builders' homes and use the ranch house.
That's correct.
The community center.
Yes. Yeah.
That is really, really, really great. And by the way, you know, one of the neat things that you guys are doing there, I think as a community, you must have some sort of staff that runs that community center, and they maybe create little programs that, because you guys have put on concerts.
Yeah. I'm so glad you asked about that, Cheryl. Yeah. So we have this amazing ranch staff that comes with just a library of amenities and activities. I mean, everywhere from, you know, they put together a flag football team for the, you know, the husbands that want to get out and be competitive.
Oh, yeah.
We've got...
They don't want to be competitive.
Right, right.
They're looking out there being kids again.
That's right.
Okay, so that means competitive again.
Yeah, they do a dog day at the pool at the end of summer where everybody brings their dogs to jump in the pool. They do s'mores over the outdoor fire pit for the kids. Story time that we invite people outside of the community. Bring your kids in. Enjoy the lifestyle factor of this community.
Oh, that is so great. You know, story time, because I know in the libraries, story time for young moms and little kids is really, really popular, and young dads. It's a great time to be able to bond, and don't our kids need that kind of story
time? It really is.
Of course, that's the educator in me speaking out, because I do believe in it.
Yeah. So, you know, I mean, this is a very small list that I've just given you on what they do there. But really what creates the lifestyle of the community is, you know, just recently we had a couple of families go through some real hardships. A lady was hit by a car head on, legally a paraplegic now. And family, their five-year-old, got diagnosed with leukemia.
Uh-huh.
So the ranch house and the residents came together and had a fundraiser. Costco donated all the spaghetti. We volunteered time. And a lot of us, we raised over $2,500 for these two families from just the residents. And that tells you how cohesive a group of people live in there.
Wow. You know, that is really, really great, because that's not something you're going to find in your average neighborhood
by any means.
When you have the cohesiveness of the ranch house, the community center, kind of pulling everybody together, this is what makes it a success.
Yeah.
We got more to share with you on the Springs Radio Real Estate Show. Get your paper and pens ready, because we got Property Showcase coming up in a flash.
Education, the key to success in life. Red Rocks Institute of Colorado Springs can give you that key. Classes, events, workshops, and webinars. This can help you learn and give you a platform to teach your passion. Red Rocks Institute offers a wide variety of classes of interest, from money management, real estate, investments, mortgage, insurance, retirement planning, and more. Red Rocks Institute, an adult education center designed to empower people with knowledge. For more information, go to redrocksinstitute.com.
It's a big, big house with lots
Hey, welcome back to the Springs Radio Real Estate Show. It's Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties. And you know what? It is a big, big house. I got a couple of properties I'm going to share with you here right now. And the very first one is the one over in Stetson Hills. This is really a big house for the dollar. I mean, I cannot believe it. So this is one in Stetson Hills, and it's got over 3,400 square feet. 3,400 square feet, four bedrooms, four baths, just really, really, really large and spacious there. Now, it's priced at $289.5. Now, Mike, this gets this down to a price point of about $84 a square foot.
That's phenomenal.
You know that in the industry, that is really phenomenal, particularly today. What would you say the average per square foot cost is today, say, of your average, say, $250,000 or $300,000 home?
Yeah, I mean, you're definitely going to be in excess of $100,000.
Yeah.
You know, a $250,000, you're probably going to be right around that $120,000, $125,000 a foot. Ranches are going to be a little bit more, you know, $130,000 and up a square foot. It's pretty typical.
Right. So, you know, this is really an outstanding value. And this home has been completely updated, built in 1996. Like I said, four bedrooms, four baths, over 3,400 square feet, two-car attached garage. It is totally updated, ready for you. It's got a total remodeled kitchen. Do you see that kitchen in those photos there,
oh,
Mike?
It's gorgeous.
It is. Brand new granite countertops, new fixtures, all the new hardwood flooring. This thing is just really ready to rock and roll. And it's just got lots and lots of sunshine. And even in the basement, the bathrooms are light and bright. It's really going to be a pleasure to go ahead and show you this home.
Got tall vaulted ceilings. Paint looks fresh.
Absolutely.
Shows very nicely.
And you know what? You need to go ahead and call me so I can show you this home. I want you to call me so I can show you this home. You need to see this home. 719-321-7600. That is your pathway to success with Cheryl Garlock at your side. Okay, I got one more I want to share with you here. And this one here is over in the Broadmoor Bluffs area. Now, this is for the folks who want to live in the southwest part of town, especially if you like living by NORAD where it's nice and safe and your garage doors go up now and then once in a while. I'm teasing. Okay, I do live over there, but nevertheless, it is kind of funny. We sort of joke about that there. You know, you never know what's going on with NORAD up there, but it's a gorgeous, gorgeous area. And I have to tell you, the mountain views, when you wake up in the morning and you get to go ahead and step out onto your porch and look at the mountain views from your homes right there in Broadmoor Bluffs, there's just nothing more refreshing and intriguing. So this home is priced at $375,000, four bedrooms, four baths, over 2,700 square feet with a three-car garage attached. These are custom homes, folks, so you need to take a look at this one. And this one here has, like I said, spectacular views of Cheyenne Mountain and, of course, the city as well. It's got granite and stainless steel appliances in the kitchen. It's got a stucco exterior and a tile roof. What do you think of those photos there, Mike, as far as the kitchen and the living areas?
It's wonderful. I mean, the house looks like it flows well from the photos, and curb appeal's great.
Oh, yeah.
Landscaping.
And what do you think about the views off? This thing is perched high up on a hill.
Gorgeous.
It is absolutely gorgeous. Now, listen, I got to tell you, on this one here, if you're thinking about buying a home like this at $375,000, and say you put 10% down with today's interest rate at about 4 3/8, you're looking at a principal and interest payment just under $1,700 a month here. And you got to add a little bit for taxes and insurance, but there's no HOA. And on the other one that was on Stetson Hills there, as I was telling you, that one was priced at $289.5. If you're doing that on a VA loan, say at 4 1/4, no money down, you're looking at a payment at about $1,425 plus your taxes and insurance. And again, there's no HOA fee. And the taxes are very reasonable on these properties. These are really, really, really reasonable. So you need to give me a call so I can show them to you. 719-321-7600. Go to ColoradoSpringsBestHomes.com. You can search all the homes for sale, new and resale, right there, ColoradoSpringsBestHomes.com at your fingertips there. You can just click on the Search Homes tab, and you're going to have two different ways to navigate through our portals there. So you can either search by a map, an interactive map search, or you can fill in the blanks, you know, when you say how many bedrooms and where you want it, all that good stuff. So you're going to want to go ahead and do that. Call me, 719-321-7600. I want to help you find your next home. We'll be right back with more from the Springs Radio Real Estate Show, so hang in there.
Are you planning to sell your home in today's competitive market? Cheryl Garlock and Colorado Front Range Properties can get the job done. Here's what others are saying.
Cheryl did an incredible job of creating a virtual tour of our house and property, which was very appealing and professionally done. She was in constant communication and offered very sound and professional advice.
As a former teacher, Cheryl has a heart to educate and protect your interests. Call Cheryl today, 719-321-7600. Online, ColoradoSpringsBestHomes.com.
Hey, welcome back to the Springs Radio Real Estate Show. I'm Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties. And, you know, first and foremost, you need this phone number. Bury it in your minds. You guys are going to always want it. 719-321-7600. Yes, indeed. You get me directly. I want to talk to you about real estate, what your needs are, what your questions are. That's what I do for a living, and I enjoy helping people. I do sell a lot of real estate, and I like to help you sell your home, help you find that next home to buy. Now, with all of that means I want to share with you some market information. Mike's going to be able to help me with this a little bit because he sees it from a little bit different perspective working in the new home construction industry. But overall, you know, statistically here, you know, our market is improving in the Colorado Springs area. I just want to share some information with you guys here. And that is that year over year, September of 2012 versus September of 2013, we have seen prices of property on an average close for 9% more. So last year, 2012, September was $223,497. Now our average pricing is $245,177. So that's pretty good. Now, we did actually end up earlier on the summer months here. We were actually in the mid-250s there. So we've softened a little bit, and probably a lot has to do with the fact that now kids are getting into school and that sort of thing, so things sort of slow down a little bit. And then things start picking back up, certainly right after the holidays. Mm-hmm. And you know that really, really well. Spring is a big time as far as that's concerned there. Now, let me also talk to you a little bit about what the market indicator means here, too, as far as absorption rates. That's really where it's an indication of what kind of a market is. You know, so is it a seller's market? Is it a buyer's market? Is it a balanced market? So they talk about that in terms of an absorption rate. So when we take and we determine that what we have here is a 20% absorption rate going on in Colorado Springs, Redfin defines an absorption rate above 20% as a seller's market and a rate below 15% as a buyer's market. Well, we're right there at 20%. So we're really pretty much a balanced market. Now, coupled with that understanding, you have to own it, and you do need to understand, don't you think, Mike, whether it's a buyer's market or a seller's market?
Most definitely.
It happens, it deals with your marketing and what you're selling things at and how fast things move.
That's right.
So speaking about how fast things move, we look at inventory. So how many months' supply of inventory do we have on the market here? Well, tell you the truth, right now, we were only at about 4, but we're almost close to 5 months. And when you have an inventory rate, that means that it takes about 4 to 5 months to sell a property. That's what you can pretty much expect right now. But when you're selling these properties less than 4 months, that's more of a seller's market. Seems obvious, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
And then a buyer's market is when it's like 7 or more months. So that balanced market is really kind of 4 to 6 months.
Yep.
That's really the average. So don't freak out if you need to sell it tomorrow. It might not happen tomorrow, but here's what you got to do. And there's all sorts of ways we can create that fast sale. If you need that fast sale, of course, you're going to fork it over in some terms of dollars as well. But it depends if that's not an advantage move for you to do as well.
Sure.
So there's always pros and cons as far as that's concerned. And, you know, we've also seen, along with those prices increasing, come along with the volume of sales year over year. So our volume of sales from September of 2012 to September, in comparison to September of 13, were up 18% plus. And 18%.
That's impressive.
That is impressive. So, you know, right now I think we have a little bit of a slowdown here to a certain degree just because people are concerned a little bit about sequestration. You know, certainly right now the debt ceiling and certainly right now the shutdown here, that sort of thing, and jobs in general here. But I really think I got to tell you this. Don't let it slow you down. Don't let it slow you down. And the reason is that if you're looking to make the best purchase of your life, you're not going to get a better price tag than you are right now. And most definitely, you're not going to get a better interest rate. The interest rates here today are hovering right around that 4.25%, 4.5% mark. And that is nothing to shy away from, because when it's gone, it's gone. And I'm not 100% certain, but I'm going to venture a guess, having done this for, just a few, like 30 years, I would say next springtime, we're going to start seeing things definitely move up more towards that 5 and 5.5%. And when that happens, you would agree, Mike, that shortens your buying power. It condenses it.
Absolutely. Every tick up in interest rate, you lose purchase power. Mm-hmm. So yeah, buy now, because it's still almost free money. And you know what? Rates haven't been this low, ever.
No.
I mean, we're still at historic lows. So just because it's up, a point from what was, last year, 3.25, 3.5, hovering in those areas, this is an amazing time to invest in real estate.
Absolutely. Now, I want to talk to you really quickly, as I only have a couple of minutes left. If you're thinking about selling your home, there are a few things you need to do to get it ready for the market, to get the best dollar that you can. And so what you really want to do is what I call practice the art of illusion. Now, if you want to know how to do this in your home and you're thinking about selling your home, you know what you can do? Yes. Yes, you do. You call me, 719-321-7600. I'm going to show you how to take that home and make that home look roomier, and what you can do with that, because you're going to practice the art of illusion to invite and entice other people to want to buy your home. Give me a call, 719-321-7600. I know what you need, and I'm going to give you some great ideas. Hey, till next week, stay good, stay warm, enjoy the Halloween holiday when it comes up here, I think in another couple of weeks here. And don't forget that cemetery crawl in Fountain here today, later on this afternoon. Thanks so much, and we'll talk to you later.
You've been listening to Springs Radio Real Estate with Cheryl Garlock, a show about all things real estate and home related for the Springs and Colorado. Go to springsradiorealestate.com to sign up for special offers and events, to listen to past shows, for educational articles, and to find links to all guests for your home and real estate needs. Cheryl would love to hear from you for questions and show ideas. Email her, Cheryl@springsradiorealestate.com.